Good morning, and thank you very much for joining us. I am Yori Folare. Tomorrow is a big day in the sense that there's an election, a rerun election in Rivers State, and it's like all eyes are on Rivers State. But the administration, the PDP government in Rivers State, doesn't seem that secure about matters because, as you're probably aware by now, the government, through its Commission of Information, actually sent out an appeal, a letter to the African Union, US, China, to help help us with the conduct of this election, because they weren't sure, they don't feel secure that fairness will prevail. Now, there is plenty of reason for worry. There's been tension in Rivers in the lead up to this election. My guest and I, let me just tell you about Alistair Wilcox, who is in the house. Thank you very much for coming on.
Nice. You're looking quite kinky.
Well, there's some very serious business on ground, so I don't know how you even noticed that.
Thank you very much. No, they still have to be humor.
Thank you very much. We have to have keep our sense of sanity, but exactly. Worrying things have been happening. For instance, the army has actually confirmed that it has lost some men in the situation, the horrible situation going on in River State. If we're going to be losing men, and not just men, soldiers, Nigerian army soldiers. Where there has actually been an allegation from the PDP that a spurious list of ad hoc members or staff of INEC has been released. This has been denied. We'll get to that. But I suppose the best thing to do is let's just do a recap when TVC News put this story out as a package yesterday, and then we'll come back to studio. Stay with us, please.
The materials arrived at INEC headquarters by 9 a.m. under the watchful eyes of political party agents, the press, security men, and staff of the commission. Shortly afterwards, sorting began. This was followed by final allocation of the materials to all 23 local government areas in Rivers State. As dispatching of the materials continued into late evening, party representatives say they are satisfied with the exercise so far.
You cannot say everything is okay because we have not gotten to the end point. So far as we are on, the processes so far, from delivery from CBN, receiving from INEC, now we are on distribution. All that is going on well.
Many that have had that misconception that River State is engulfed in crisis, they will get to know that all we started doing since morning has been peaceful. There has been no agitations, there has been no fight between the various political party agents that are here represented.
Despite the thumbs up given by some political parties, the process has not been entirely hitch-free. For instance, some result sheets for Emoha and Obiakpo councils are discovered to be missing.
In Emoha, 6 wards, the results were not found. We believe it may have been a result of packaging. So we want to wait until all the LGAs have been sorted. We can now find if it's there.
But the leadership of INEC in the state has assured of a plan B if the missing result sheets are not found at the end of distribution.
Yeah, it is missing. Then we'll get the result sheet on the field by tomorrow. We wouldn't want that to happen. So we started raising the petition. We are going to sign and submit to the officials of INEC for record purposes, that even if at the end of the day they give us what they call the replacement sheet, let it be known to the whole world that it is the result on the replacement sheet that is the genuine result and not any other one from any other sheet.
The River State Resident Electoral Commissioner Aniedi Ikoiwak says these sensitive materials will be deployed to 315 registration area centers across the state for onward deployment to about 6,000 voting points on election day. Uche Okoro, TVC News, Port Harcourt.
So that was, the news package that went out yesterday on TVC News on sensitive materials being delivered to River State. So, Alistair, going by that report, things seem to be in order.
Well, we have always seen, things have always been all the time when there's election seems to be in order. There's no time that distribution of materials or parties things does not seem to be in order. They always seem to be in order. But the problem is, after being in order, what is the aftermath of that being in order?
Okay.
Because right now you're hearing that some result sheets for Emoha, for Obiakpo are missing and all whatnot. Under normal circumstances, they shouldn't pose a problem.
Mm-hmm.
But because of the our past experiences, so tomorrow now, like yesterday, this since we have moved to local government,
yes.
And if I tell about River State, it's about 60% water and about 40% land, or about 50-50, I can't say. Now they are showing you the vehicles conveying the ones for the land. What of the boats and the vessels that will convey the ones that are going to River? And I'm telling you, a local government like Andoni local government is right into the sea, very close to Akwa Ibom. Opobo, the same thing. My own local government, Borno, the same thing. These are one you can't access by land, only by sea. So, what are the plans made for those?
So it's it's a complex operation.
Quite complex. Yes.
And as we've said, there's been tension. The eyewitness on the tape was saying, "Look, people have a notion that Rivers is high tension; it's on fire." He seemed to be was seeking to douse that impression a bit.
Well, if he's seeking, his body language has betrayed him, because if you see him, he doesn't look settled. His person, his manner, he doesn't look settled.
You think?
Yes, from what you see, from what I can read of his
well, there are a number of reasons.
Because I tell you, nobody should be under an illusion that there is no tension in River State. For you to give a 2 days holiday for election that does not involve the governor.
Yeah.
You're only having, it's a state election because it's the senatorial, three senatorial seats cover the entire state. The 12 House of Rep covers almost the entire state, apart from one reconstituent, which may be more than two local governments. The state assembly will cover at least, out of 23, covers some reasonably 18 local governments, 18 to 17 to 18 local governments. So the senatorial covers, so it's like a state where it's like a fresh election. So, and then we've had the campaign, how dirty and how
it has
hard
it,
the campaign
it,
went.
It has been very,
you know, very dirty, very uncouth languages, very inciting languages coming from the political gladiators. And President, embarrassingly, when the governor keeps saying kill, kill, kill.
The acrimony in the build-up to this election.
I do not understand. You see, sincerely speaking, I respect the governor. I respect Governor Yenson Wike very well. But I don't understand his penchant for kill, kill, kill.
Okay. And, talking about that, on the unfortunate situation where the army actually confirmed that it had lost men in the fracas there.
Yeah.
I think we have some pictures of that as well. The killings of soldiers in the melee there. We don't have the actual sound. Okay, but you know that was when the army actually confirmed that,
yes,
beyond it being a rumor or anything like that. So it's a very, very serious affair going on.
Yori, I want to say a bit on that.
Sure.
2 days ago, it was reported that the governor in one of his campaign trail made certain terrible statement, which I will call very terrible. It said if the chief of army staff come to River State to do anything, he won't go back alive. If the Fulani president comes to take over his security in River State, he will send him to his ancestors. This is I do not know.
This
if
is really taking
them.
Campaigning
yes,
to
I must,
another.
I want to
an
believe. I want
level.
To believe and give him benefit that he didn't say those terrible things.
Mm.
But if he has said them, then the ball has set rolling.
But
by the time you kill a major of the Nigerian army, the ripple effects can be better imagined, knowing the characteristics of our military, when they want to respond to when their own is being affected.
You don't kill any
soldier. You see, when
any
own,
soldier
when their
at all.
When their own is affected.
Yeah, I know. I understand
way,
what you mean.
The
that sometimes
they react,
you can't really predict how things will go. I understand.
Their
so there's big danger
and the unfortunate thing
in
that,
incitement is the point that you're making. I don't think we want to dwell too much on that.
The unfortunate thing is that, Jory, the people that did that will have escaped into the creeks, into the bush.
I hear you.
And if there's a reprisal,
I hear
it
you.
Is the innocent reverse man.
Well,
and
we
man
hope he won't get to that.
That
I take
suffer.
Your point.
But
and
I
every
pray.
Nigerian knows
pray,
exactly what you're saying, but I don't think we should labor this particular point as we move on. It's a dicey situation. It's not that we won't report it at all, but you know, hopefully things will return to normal. The former governor, he's going to be fully involved in this election. Yeah. He's on ground, as is his right. And the bit of, I don't know, the apprehension that the government in Potter in Rivers has is that he's coming to town. But what he was putting out, what the former governor was putting out, was that, look, don't worry about security. Everybody that wants to vote should come out and vote, and there will be no hassle, no, that at least, you know, former Governor Amaechi, now Minister Amaechi, has been sort of encouraging people of Rivers.
No, exactly. I think with the arrival of Amaechi last Sunday, you know, it's like when, you know, the days of David and Goliath, when Goliath was threatening fire and brimstone, the entire army of Israel went into hiding. And when David came up and slayed Goliath, they all stood up and started shouting. I think the whole APC apparatus was silenced by the governor. He boasted, he shouted to anybody that cares to listen. Things were happening, mm-hmm. and the whole APC, I don't think they were campaigning, they all went into hiding. You know, they felt left out, but Amaechi seems to be their champion. Rotimi Amaechi seems to be their champion, so he came in with encouraging word. And
well,
so
because as you know, APC has said that its own were being targeted.
No,
for
no,
these
but
killings.
It's true. But it's true.
That its own were being targeted by these killings, and it was thinking that look, these things can't be going on like this.
Exactly,
this, this is just.
And I think that was why the minister had to relocate.
Yes.
Maybe he took leave, which is entirely, I don't know.
This is crass.
I don't know why he left his duties in Abuja, but I guess he could have taken casual leave, official leave, or whatever, to come to, because he's the leader of the APC in Rivers State.
In Rivers.
And he has to mobilize his army in order to galvanize them, in order to, because this is a real context of ego now. Now, what happened in 2013, in 2015, sorry.
Before we go, let me just also recall that I think, well, we've looked at the whole matter of sensitive materials arriving. There was an allegation about some sensitive materials, and INEC has denied it, that it didn't, it doesn't have this list that that is scaring the opposition, the ruling party. It doesn't have this spurious list of ad hoc staff members. There is no such thing. Let's see what we can get from there.
The Rivers INEC commissioner was reacting to allegations by the ruling PDP in the state that it was in possession of a list containing names of some APC members as ad hoc staff for the elections. The PDP added that the sensitization meeting convened by the police presented a list before security operatives and other stakeholders which contained names of some APC members allegedly being engaged as ad hoc staff.
We mark names of truly APC members. True APC. They are not just, they are true APC registered members. Details are here. Some of them are candidate relations. Their names are here. And that is a name that was compiled by invoice of Port Harcourt and sent to INEC. We know who compiled the list. We know the candidate who joined that doctor to compile the list. And we are aware of it. How do we know? It's our business. And we brought it to the fore. But since we talk about it, no one has said anything.
INEC faulted the allegation, saying the commission had never at any time published names of any ad hoc staff for the elections.
I have listened to so many insinuations on list flying and so on. I have not taken any list from any political party. I have not. And that is, they can testify that that is the first time in this state that nobody has applied to be INEC staff, to be INEC ad hoc staff. Nobody. In this election, nobody has applied to be ad hoc staff.
An APC senatorial candidate in Rivers State has expressed worry over a recent attack on him.
Political leaders can use the money, the resources of Rivers State to make coffins, and they write on those coffins, Magnus Abe is dead. And then political leaders, people who expect young people to listen to them, people who should live by example, will walk behind those coffins and be sharing tracts to people, telling them that I will die and I am dead. And everybody in this country keeps quiet and allows that kind of thing to go on unchallenged.
The trading of blames notwithstanding, members of both the PDP and APC say they are prepared for the rerun elections. For now, expectations are high that the exercise would be conducted peacefully, given the assurances from the police. Edmund Awaje, TVC News.
Okay, now let's swing to our man in River State right now, Andy Orewari, so he can give us a sort of situation report. What's on ground now? Andy, good morning.
Good morning, Uncle Yori.
Hey, good morning, my brother. So, what's give us the situation. What's it like now? Are we prepared?
Yes, I want to believe the politicians, like they've always said for the past couple of days, they are prepared. But what I will also want to report is there is what I would want to describe as an uneasy calm. Uneasy calm because nobody know what next is going to happen, given that just yesterday a major and another Ameritan was killed somewhere in Abonima, even if the chief of that community had come to refute that claim that they were killed within his community. What is happening here right now is everybody is trying to be very careful. People, so many people are those that did not travel out of town, given the 2 days holiday by the state government, you know, yesterday and today,
indeed,
as we declared holidays.
Yes.
Nothing is there. The banks are not working. Just this morning, I have to dash to Aba to be able to draw some money because I don't use ATM. Mm. And so everybody is being very careful because they don't know what next is going to happen, given that Rivers politics have oftentimes recently been characterized by orgy of violence, killing and destruction of property. But the security operatives have assured that they are leaving no stone unturned in order to ensure that the rerun tomorrow is not violent. But people are just being very, very careful, and there is an uneasy calm.
You know, Andy,
from right now.
Andy, I can relate to what you report because we hear that parents are very concerned and schools. So much so that the schools decided that most schools in River State decided that just a day before the election is not enough. They actually sent messages to parents that, look, we're not open. We were closing down school from Thursday.
Hello, can you come again, Uncle Yuri?
Parents and schools seem to be so concerned that they've actually closed schools 2 days before the election instead of just a day before the election.
Yes, that is the reservation, not just parents, Okuyori, almost everybody had expressed, because before now, it's really not been that way. Worst case scenario, in 1 day to the election, but this is a new development. But the state government has said that it is all just towards ensuring security of lives and property, because that they would not want, they are not leaving anything unturned to ensure that there is no violence during this election. But people on the other side have said, why close down all businesses in the state for 2 days running, and even banks, rather than say, okay, you're working half day so that people can access, because so many people were caught off guard with this two-day holiday. But like they will say, there is nothing you can give in order to ensure security. But that is what the state government has said. That is the reason for declaring the 2 days holidays.
It's
not easy with people here.
What do you think, Andy, of the what was put out by the minister, by the Commissioner for Information in River State, this appeal or letter inviting the US, China, AU to come and help with this election? What do people in River State make of that?
Yes, incidentally, Uncle Yori, I spoke with the Commissioner for Information and Communications in River State Tuesday this week. We had an interview with him, and I asked him that why write all those, because that was where he first of all revealed that his the state government had written that was done in order to ensure that the elections are free and fair, because there is this fear that the federal government seems not to be giving the administration here a listening ear. And I asked him, how do you mean? What are your evidences to say the federal government is not giving you a listening ear and all that? He said, yeah, because the transportation minister had boasted that is going to flood everywhere with military if it's not having the backup of the federal government. He wouldn't have been able to do that. I say, well, it may just be a pronouncement. You know, you politicians can say anything in order to score the political point. He said, no, that they are leaving no stone unturned, and that was why they decided to write other foreign countries and the international organizations so as to ensure that this election is very, very free and fair. They don't want intimidation. They don't want killing. They don't want anything so that it would not be ascribed to people, because the blame game here, I must also report, has been very, very, it has gotten to a boiling point. PDP is accusing APC of doing XYZ, and APC in return is accusing PDP of all that. So nobody really knows, but that was the excuse the Commissioner for Information and Communication, Dr. Tam George, gave just Tuesday this week.
Okay, Andy, finally, give me your impression about the Minister Amechi's statement earlier that, look, nobody should be fearful of being attacked or being molested or being anything like that. The presence of security is going to be such that you are going to be so very, very secure. Now, apparently, this can be read in two ways, depending on what comes here on. So give me what your impression is of the minister saying, Minister Amechi, former governor, saying that the security presence will be such. Maybe you could start by telling me what discernible difference in security presence there is in Rivers as we speak now.
I think what the former governor tried to do is to assure people that please come out and vote because your security is assured. Because before now, political analysts in Rivers politics have said there is going to be a very high level of apathy because of what has transpired in the Orashi region, what has transpired in Ogoni before now, what has transpired in Omoku. There has been killing and all that, and so that many people would not want to participate. I want to see the transportation minister's pronouncement. He's looking at it from that perspective, encouraging people to come and vote, because of course you know that if many did not show up to vote, it will affect either ways. I think that is what he was trying to do best. Of course, you know that politicians would always want to read issues from different perspectives and all that. Mm. And I think the PDP sees that as trying to, you know, use the federal might to intimidate.
Okay.
And that is the angle they are looking at it from. I just think that I'm not trying to hold brief for the former governor, but I think that it was from that angle he said it. But also, there's been, Uncle Yori, there's been so many fireworks. Verbal fireworks, both from the APC and from the PDP camp, blame game. And so we can't just wait. The only thing we are praying for is the security operatives should do the needful, because at the end of it all, River State is what will bear the best.
Indeed.
Security operatives should do the needful to save lives and property, because as it is often said, there is nothing worth sacrificing any life for.
Okay.
And I think the Rivers people need to be careful and go to do the needful tomorrow and Sean Bowden.
I couldn't agree with you more, Andy. Finally, please, just tell me what you have observed in terms of heightened security, if anything at all. Presence of security, men in uniform, is there any of that as of now?
Yes. There is so much of that in Port Harcourt Metropolis right now. And I also heard that some of them have already been deployed to adjoining local government and other parts of it. But for instance, last night, I left the office at about past 9. I didn't get to my house, not after about 1.5 hours, because there was serious traffic gridlock along the popular Aba Road in Port Harcourt, where you have the INEC Secretariat. That as I was coming to the office this morning from the Aba access, like I earlier reported, there is also security. I think all this is to ensure that there is no violence, to ensure that the elections tomorrow will be free and fair. But we just hope that they would do the needful and they would ensure that what they are deployed to do is done. Because it's one thing to deploy security operatives to say, go do this, and it's yet another thing to do that which they were deployed to do.
Thank you very much, Andy. Excellent
so much,
job. All right, yes. Then. Our Bureau Chief, Andy Oreweri in Rivers State. Well, we have something of a slightly better sense now, don't we?
Yes.
So, but what is coming through is that this is one of those elections that you just can't take for granted.
No, no,
no way cannot. You say there's no tension.
No, you just cannot. You see, like Andy is saying, our time changes. By this time last year, the APC is the one shouting, oh, they brought fake lists. security operatives are on their harassing us. They want to flood us. They want to intimidate us. And how the ball have changed. You know, when in 2000, and I've said it, when 2015 election, when the PDP was even fighting it, was even the one cause against itself, when there was no need for the shenanigans that took place, they took it overboard. And that is why we were having a general election in the state. You know, and I, when the 2015 election was terribly flawed and mad in reverse. I say it was the Supreme Court that saved the governor. And of course, he knows that the Supreme Court that was that saved. And I expected that he would have acted differently from what he's doing now. You know, because then there was no election. Well, for the court, the university was not the only state that went to court. Every other state went to court. Every other state went to court with all their senatorial candidates, with House of Rep. Every other state went to court. But for every state to have this massive cancellation of that shows how massive the
exactly,
this thing was.
Because yeah. that point needs to be made that this is a rerun election.
Completely rerun.
Because it was
massive.
Was no election in the actual sense of the word.
Because, the killing didn't start today. It's been there since 2011. You understand? It's just that during the election, during the period of litigation, since 2015, during the period of litigation, yes, there was a law because everybody was like, oh, Wike was also like, am I going, am I not going? Everybody was uncertain. When all the senators were returned, all their House of Representatives. So, I mean, there was that fear. So everybody was just minding. It was busy trying to appease the people. Quite some good infrastructure development, like in the road sector, opened up a lot of good roads and everything. But the moment his election was confirmed, he arrived from the Thanksgiving service. He was telling how Peter Odili sent him to this and this. At the other side, he was saying, calling those who come to still voting, calling Nigerian Army, Boko Army. So it went really overboard. And like I said,
well, yeah.
This is the time that
sort
there
of
is
maybe just
balance
reassure
of
people.
Power in terms of electoral fortune. Balance
okay.
of power
well,
is
we've got to go
happening.
To a short break now, as we always do around this time. But when we come back, we'll just leave the phones wide open to hear contributions from you. There might even be people who have, you know, who are watching this in River State and might be able to phone in their impressions. There might be people who just come back or might have particular insights. We'll be ready for all of that as soon as we get back. Welcome back. We're all keeping our fingers crossed for tomorrow. As much as possible, preparations are in high gear. Our sensitive materials have been delivered, but there's still a lot of hot air going on there. As we said before, the sitting government in River State, the PDP sitting government, you know, has actually written outside of the country to get people in to help them. So it shows that people are concerned. We hope we can get calls in from River State, but wherever this is the subject, that's not just for River State.
Yeah.
It concerns everybody.
Because when INEC conducts some of the run, they do 2-3 states together. This one is just one state, only River State.
Mm.
And I asked, what are you writing the embassies for, the 50 embassies?
I don't know.
Are they the INEC?
Exactly.
Are they going to send army or what?
Let's hear Ebuka's take from Kaduna. Good morning, Ebuka.
Yeah, good morning, Uncle Yori.
Thank you for calling in.
Oh, thank you so much. To be frank with you, I enjoy your program. It is very, very,
very
sometimes
kind.
I thought provoking and, you know, informative.
Very kind of
you. I'll ask a question. These political gladiators, like the gentleman which you refer them to, I also end up and asking myself, do they have the interest of the common Nigerians at heart? All this violence and bloodshedding and all that, they really care about those they govern or those to whom they make legislative rules and all that for? That is one. Two, the comment by the present governor of Rivers State, if, because I actually stumbled on an online news where he said that in the Fulani enters Port Harcourt, he should be beaten up.
Yeah,
you understand. Now it calls to the kind of governors we have ruling our state. Should they not be checked up psychologically and mentally to know their feet? All kind of statements, don't they call for review of kind of, you know, the kind of persons we have ruling us?
I hear
every,
you. Well,
opportunity create an avenue to make insightful statements and raise angers. So people really have interest of the common man in the street.
It is.
Be it APC, PDP, whatever government or whatever, let it be free and fair for all. Let the best man wear the cap and do, you know, let it be for the interest of for everybody.
I hear you, Ebuka. Thank you very much for calling in. We really appreciate your call. Because the acrimonious language going on in there must be worrying.
No, quite.
Very, very worrying.
No, quite. Well, and that's
potential.
Said, and that's what I say, sometimes.
Potential for a spark,
yes,
to hit a.
You said, the governor is the chief security officer, and he's supposed to be more, even if Amechi goes over.
More discreet.
Yeah, more discreet. You are calling Buhari a Fulani president. The chief of army said, if he comes to River State, he will not go back alive.
I'm reminded of the late Alhaji Waziri Ibrahim, the proponent of politics without bitterness. I mean, I wonder what he would be thinking now.
Isn't
this contest about going to serve the people?
The people.
Isn't this contest about being a servant?
And Governor Wike and Minister Mechi do not even have any direct interest, in this matter. Maybe Wike is only trying to save. It get enough member of the House of Assembly to have a free reign.
Yeah.
And of course, Amechi too is also wanting to show that he is also a power.
Yes.
And they can rock the boat. Nevertheless, if the Supreme Court gives you victory, they can also rock the boat with House of Assembly.
Okay.
So that's what is at stake here.
Okay. Good morning, Yakub.
Yeah, good morning, Chief Yori.
Thank you for calling in.
Chief Yori, let's be sincere with ourselves in this country. We will continue to find ourselves in this kind of situation whereby sitting governor will make an utterance that can make people in the state to take weapons against each other. Why is it that? A situation whereby, you know, whatever you get a position of a political office, you are already rich. Because the money that is there is too much. If they can be able to amend our constitution, a situation whereby a politician, a governor will be collecting salary as a full servant. You bet me on you. That is a time you will not see a very good people aspire to be a governor in this country. All these people that you are seeing, I'm sorry to say, to mention it, somebody like your Governor Wike, if you see the way the man normally talks, Yori, you will ask yourself a question. Is he a sitting governor? Look at the last caller. Look at what he said. A situation where the governor said that if somebody comes to that state, it will not go free. And then yesterday, or if I'm correct, they killed a major in that state. And then if a soldier now go to that very particular location or village and begin to take the weapon and retaliate, people will now say so Nigerian soldier they are doing something in respect of something that they are not ought to do. And then you kill a soldier, you kill a major because you want to become a governor. Is that a welcome development?
Okay then.
God almighty help of the new country. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you very much, Yakub. Apprehension is very, very high.
Yeah.
Things are going on that ought, you know, these things ought not so to be.
It certainly ought not to have been.
We
shouldn't have gone to this level, Yori, if the people of River State has behaved themselves in March last year. I mean, the bankruptcy and all the malpractice of that election was terribly obvious. So, I mean, and I've always said it, that election was for the PDP and Wike to have won that election. Clear. If they had even allowed the voting to have taken place, very well. They might lose one or two seats, but they would have won the election and wouldn't have found themselves in this condition.
Blessing Okwebi, good morning.
Good morning, Mr. Yori.
Good morning, madam.
God will assist us in this country. We all know the truth, but we don't want to talk. But God will see assist us.
Tell us some of that truth, madam.
Exactly.
Tell
us the truth.
Now, you people are saying one governor there is saying something or not. The same thing happened during Amechi's time. Did Amechi not use strong song on people? You see, PDP, APC, let me tell you one thing. None of them have the interest of Nigeria at heart. If they have the interest of Nigeria at heart, none of them will open their mouth and say that kind of a thing. Because their children is not here, their wife is not here, their family is not here, they have money to fly them to abroad. For the stupid Nigerians and some youth, they will kill themselves because of all these people that doesn't care for them. They've closed Yabatech now since how many years? Because none of the government students say their children are there, so they don't care. Now again, you will vote them in. You cannot see them. You cannot call them. You cannot see them. When they are coming, even their entourage, they will almost clear you a road. People that we vote for will now become their enemy. If you want to pass, they will bring up. So it's you. Children will be there. People that we kill, we vote for, that will be these people. But God will deliver us from them. I support Yakub and the other man that is coming. We, the followers, should think twice and know what we are doing. Mr. Yori, we are suffering. These people, they don't have our interests at heart. People and talent.
All right, then. Thank you very much, Madam Blessing.
Madam Blessing speaking
from the heart.
Part of the truth. And, you know, which we have heard,
speaking
I mean,
from the heart.
But she said nobody speaks the truth. We've been speaking the truth.
Well, I mean, everybody
is speaking the truth.
It's her own way of expression.
Maybe people want us to speak what they want to hear alone.
No.
Maybe
that
is the truth.
It doesn't really bother about critiquing her response.
The end of the heartache was quite instructive. And I said it on Silver for us. Reverse people that are killing themselves. We all come from the same, almost like, we live in a community. If you go to my village now, and there's no house I've not eaten, there's no house anybody has not eaten in that village. If you come to my village in December, you would think we are all from one family.
Since you are a reverend,
yes.
So what then is the issue when it now comes to applying for a job to be a servant?
Mm-hmm.
That's what it is.
That's stupidity. It's
applying for a job to be a servant.
Exactly.
Apparently, the job is not that of a servant.
Of course.
Kill themselves to come and be a servant.
Of course, they don't.
So something else must be involved. That's where the problem is.
The resources are valuable to officers, which is part of the truth that some of the people said. Those available to office holders is humongous.
Okay.
Wike came into government, the first thing we did was to borrow 40 billion to repair roads and everything. And that is quite humongous money.
Wait a minute, I beg your pardon. Alex is in Port Harcourt right now and he wants to join the program.
Good
morning, Alex.
Good morning.
Thank you for calling in.
Thank you. The issue of River State is something that we need to look beyond political division in River State. The truth of the issue, just like the last caller said, the problem in River State. Good morning. Good morning to you, sir.
Thank you very much. Please go ahead. Continue.
Okay. I'll do that. The issue of political River State is beyond PDP and APC.
True.
The truth of the issue, none of these political parties are thinking about the common people in River State or Nigeria as a whole. The situation we are having in Port Harcourt now, right now, is beyond political party. All of them, they are just thinking about their service, their interests. Either APC or PDP, not one of them is thinking about this common man on the street. River State right now is boiling everywhere, just setting confusion about our leader.
But Alex? Alex, when you say the issue in River State is beyond the political parties, then who is it up to?
The truth of this, my brother, there is a way you look at the whole situation in the first place. Are you hearing me?
We can hear you. Please continue.
Okay. So, as I say, none of these political parties think about this, taking this country from. We are not even having a leader.
Okay.
They want to rule us by force. Either APC or PDP, they don't just want to rule the common man by force.
Huh.
That's just the truth of the issue.
But that's what elections seek to solve. Not by force.
But by choice.
But by choice. The elections provide for us to have a by choice, you know, winner.
Before he can get the right people on the seat, he have to go through a political party. Mm-hmm. That's just the issue of the issue. That's just the problem we are having.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much for calling in, Alex. Appreciate your call.
Is it your River State used to have this problem of upland, riverine dichotomy. But this is not about it. Because the two gladiators are equations. The two gladiators are upland. Amechi was insisting that, look, it's time for the riverine, because since 1979, the upland has been producing the governor. He said, no, it's for the riverine. And now the Jonathan factor came. Let me just, people don't know, what is the Jonathan factor?
Okay.
That is just what is playing out.
You think the origin of this
is the Jonathan factor?
Is the Jonathan factor.
Full stop. That the origin of this current is the Jonathan factor. I mean, the river, and as I said, the PDP had a good stand chance. They had the odds in their favor in last year to have won the election clean, clear. The odds were in their favor. The Jonathan factor was working very hard. The problem is the fact that, oh, they said he betrayed Jonathan, his kinsman, for a Fulani man. Mm-hmm. That is just a grouse. Mm. And now they've taken it to this level of assassination, beheading, wiping off of families and all what, which is just
it's almost unbelievable.
And I tell you sometimes, President Jonathan is in our history. The man is enjoying his retirement in his village or somewhere and taking award internationally. Mm. Why keep drinking Panadol on another man's headache, for goodness sake?
Okay, Yusuf from Mushin, good morning.
Good morning. Yeah, the issue of River State politics, as one woman I just said earlier, is beyond your analysis. And more to politics playing on in River State. And when you follow the political scenario, you start from the court proceedings. And you find it so difficult to understand our legal process in this country. A judgment delivered to a governor that says you are not the winner of the election. That judgment on Kadrida was given to another governor that there must be a rerun in that state. So, to an extent, that the PDP have seen the APC, that they have it at all costs for them to take over River State and all other always states. And I'm surprised that you continue mentioning the Governor Wike said. But you didn't mention what the minister was saying.
Such as
he has soldiers and he has the federal government backing, that he will move with soldiers, will he do this, he will do that.
Well, I'm not too sure that you are exactly accurate, Yusuf. I mean, but thank you all the same. Thank you. Because if I understood it, maybe what Yusuf misunderstood was the appeal by Amechi for people to come out and
yes,
not
that
be fearful,
will be, in fact,
that there will be enough security
speaking,
on ground.
Yori, 6,000 policemen that the IG said he's sending is a child's play. And I said it on some other fora. Boni local government, the landmass, the water and landmass between Boni, Opobo, Nkoro, and the local government is bigger than Ekiti State. And if at that time you were doing election in Ekiti State, you had about 50,000 security personnel on a landlocked environment. You're talking of the sea of a, so 6,000 is a child's play. The army, both from the one at Bodi Camp, the one at Enugu, the one at Obinze in Imo State, they must be fully involved for you to have absolute peace and tranquility in conducting elections.
So one understands the need to draft in more personnel, but that's probably what Yusuf
understand. I mean, he doesn't understand the issue because, I mean,
he doesn't understand the issue at all. It's just that we wanted to affect, you know, just.
I mentioned never say Olundo brings without to kill anybody.
That's the only part.
So.
That's the only part that needed correction.
Yes.
You can't say he didn't understand the issue for all everything else.
Okay.
He said.
Okay. Well, if you do.
Mr. Dede Ikeja, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Thank you for calling in.
God bless you, sir. Mr. Lester, good morning.
Thank you, Mr. Dede.
Yeah. I am not from River State, but we have been monitoring what has been happening in that state for so long. I wouldn't know why people keep saying that former Governor Amechi is a problem of River State, because I've heard it in many mass media.
people keep saying that our governor, former Governor Amaechi, why did he leave the transportation ministry in Abuja and come back to Rivers to fight for election, all this and that. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't know where these people are coming from. Do they expect that he will leave his own base to run elections and we will not have an input? Then when people say that this thing is a balance of terror, I don't know where they are coming from, really. Because I have listened to all the statements made by Amaechi. I think the most repugnant of the thing that he said was that you should vote out the PDP to shame Jonathan, vote out PDP to shame Patience, vote out PDP to shame Wiki. None of the statements as if stated that people should take up arms. But I have listened to Governor Wiki. At least I have three occasions that he has been instigating people to take up arms against of the opposition. In one of his statements, he said they should beat up Amaechi whenever they see him. So I didn't know where people, when they say there is a balance of terror. Of all these people that have been killed, more than 90% of them are APC members. And the governor has not seen anything wrong in it. Since last year, when people were killed in the last election, he has not made any attempt to bring to book those who have perpetrated all this crisis. And he is the governor. I remember that when Amaechi came into power, things were so terrible that people could not move freely in River State. But he stood his ground. And he made sure that he restored peace at all costs to that state. Yeah. But ever since this governor came in, he has, by his utterances, by his actions, shown that he's in favor of all this violence that is going on. Maybe okay. Because the opposition to him has been the major victim. So I don't know what is wrong. I don't know why a sitting governor cannot be brought to book, okay, even when he commits crime.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Dede. Well, as we are, you know, what's it? This is the home stretch of the program that we're on now. Yeah. The River State situation is something of a work in progress. but then all hands, I am sure, are on deck. And we just will be hoping for the best.
Yeah,
there's apprehension in the air.
You see, let's hope that but the rivers, the rivers people will seize this opportunity to write their electoral name in the sense of better times now. I call that axis the South Side, the axis of electoral evil, because there has not been clean elections ever since. They failed to take advantage of even the introduction of technology, the card reader, as to redeem, like I said, also in their favor, to redeem ourselves. I'm from that state, to redeem ourselves and join other progressive part of the country in electoral matters.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the word landslide, sea slide, moonslide victory came from River State in 1983. You know, came from River State and all those things. Mm-hmm. So in our spirit of the country, everyone wants a landslide victory. Mm-hmm. But the fact is, who are being killed? Rivers people. Who is being killed? Your brother. Okay. Who is being killed? Your family member. Your community member.
I think I can squeeze in Shola from Ipaja. Good morning, Shola.
Good morning, sir.
Thank you for calling in.
Yeah, again, it's about the people. The people don't know what they want. If there is crisis, the people that are going to be shot are not part of this people that are contesting. And you will see that not until when we begin to talk to ourselves, not until when we begin to reorientate ourselves to the pattern of governance. Because Nigeria have lost it since 1979, 1983. Not until when we go back to the root and when individuals are being respected, when money politics is removed, power play is doctored, not until then, not until when we begin to change the orientation of material, where the people in power are no more respected, I mean the people in political class are no more respected as we give to them either in churches, in mosques, and social gatherings. Not until then, this kind of thing will continue. Why must we bring up soldiers? This is Africa. This is too bad. Soldiers, police, look, riots, there is a protest in Brazil right now. You just see police guiding them, no gunshot, nothing. They are seated, they are just being, this is a protest, not a voting pattern.
Mm.
You can't even think of protests in Nigeria. Everybody will be scared. I think right, we need then. To find a way. The media body should help us in finding a way of orientating our people, because election will be coming up in Ondo, another one will be coming in Osun, another election will be coming up in Ekiti. Even before the general election that will be expressing coming 2018-2019.
All right then, Ishola, thank you very much calling in from Ipaja there, and I think we can't possibly squeeze in any more calls.
Exactly.
Just Alistair Wilcox.
Yes, I think, you know, now given 2 days, like correspondent reported, closing banks, closing insurance companies, do we care about the GDP of this country, productivity?
But
you
close for 2 days. Security of life and property has to be paramount. And when people are doing this, it is not.
The election starts today.
I know, but look,
you now close schools for 2 days, close banks for 2 days, close.
So why are they doing it?
Why will they do that?
So why are they doing it?
For me,
they feel insecure.
No.
That
is even heightening the insecurity, because nobody, like who said, nobody is shooting gun on the streets. Nobody is shooting on the streets. They know where these things are, but is it for me? I think it's overzealousness
on the
part of those people to do that. So,
heighten the tension.
Yes,
but you think this has actually heightened the tension?
It has heightened the tension because it's like now.
Who caused them to be doing all of that? You blaming the weaker government?
Well, I think the buck stops on the weakest government's table, because right now he's the commander in chief of the state, chief of the state, and so anything he does, he puts on the state. So even when others are heating up the state, should be seen
just chief security officer, no commander in chief.
Okay, he should be seen to be dousing.
Okay,
they should be saying, but of course,
rather than heightening it.
But I just pray that my prayer is that every Rivers life will be secure tomorrow, and Rivers people will join the progressive train of electoral progress in this country, and let us not shame ourselves again and become responsible citizens, part of this country that will bring out a sound electoral culture, sound voting culture, sound democratic culture for this country, and I'm sure we can do it in Rivers State.
We got to leave it there. Thank you very, very much, Alistair Wilcox, Chartered Accountant and Public Affairs Analyst. I'll see you, I almost said tomorrow, but it's going to have to be Monday. We don't do a Saturday edition anymore. I'm Yori Folarin. Bye-bye for now.